हेलो सर, गुड इवनिंग।
सर गुड इवनिंग। गुड इवनिंग गॉड इन सर।
ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर। सर, डू यू हैव एनी डाउट्स एज ऑफ नाउ? हैव यू प्रैक्टिस मोर?
यस सर, आई हैव वन डाउट। सपोज वी आर से फॉर एग्जांपल वेबिनार इज बीइंग कंडक्टेड लाइक दिस सर।
ओके सर।
सपोज वी आर सेंडिंग इनविटेशन टू ऑल, बट वी वांट टू रेस्ट्रिक्ट टू से फॉर एग्जांपल 200।
Restrict to only 200.
Just for an example, I'm telling.
Okay, okay. Sir, anyhow,
okay.
One option is there, sir. You can create a group. You can create a group.
Okay.
Which consists of mail IDs to whom you want to give access.
Okay.
Let us say I want to conduct webinar for 10 students.
Okay.
So first step is I need to have those 10 students mail IDs with me.
Okay.
Once I have those mail IDs, I can send a meeting link to only particularly those 10 students.
Okay.
Then in once they are joining, generally in Google Meet, sir, whenever any person is joining with these kind of links, from my end, I need to click admit.
Then only they can join.
If you are sending, if you are creating a group and you are sending an invitation to only particular to those 10 students, you need not to every time enter admit. Automatically, you are giving authentication to those 10 students.
Oh, already we have decided. No problem.
Only those 10 students can only attend this session. If unknown people is coming, it will ask you whether you want to admit them or not.
Oh, in that case only we have to admit.
Yes.
If we want.
Yes.
Okay.
Yesterday actually for our session I used Google Calendar. From calendar you will get one request. Then so and so time you are requested to attend so and so seminar. Are you ready? They have to accept the invitation. Then in that particular time they can attend. This is full official conference kind of thing.
Oh, right.
For general thing we can share normal mail link, and we have to request them to join the particular session before the given time.
Okay. Thanks,
after that time you should not admit anyone.
Oh, right. And also I have seen the videos which you have sent, the basics and all other things.
Yes,
day
sir.
One.
Yes, sir.
That's quite useful, sir. As far as the Google Forms are concerned, I am a layman. So, you have started from the scratch and I am very much interested to learn more because of you only.
Sir, today we will see interesting things, how to customize. Okay. So, let us take the Priyadarshini madam. Madam, now are you able to connect your laptop? Please unmute yourself. Priyadarshini madam, are you there? Yes, you shared photo. Just wait. Team viewer. Professor sir, I am sharing my screen. Are you able to see? Just wait, I am sharing. Your entire screen sharing started. Yes sir. Sir, now can you see my screen? Are you able to see?
Yeah, just you are presenting, but
okay, I will open one more something. Now
I am able to see now sir.
What is
control remote computer and all that.
Thank you sir. This is what TeamViewer sir.
Okay.
With the help of this TeamViewer I can control others computer.
Okay.
For this we need to enter their partner ID, their ID. Right now I have Priyadarshini madam ID. I am entering that ID. 324982. Priyadarshini madam, please can you unmute yourself? I am entering password. Priyadarshini madam, are you there? Log on. See sir, now I am connecting to
yes, sir,
మేడం డెస్క్టాప్ స్క్రీన్
సిస్టమ్
మేడం వన్ థింగ్
మేడం వన్ థింగ్
బికాస్ యూఆర్ యూజింగ్ మొబైల్ దిస్ ఎకో ఇస్ కమింగ్ సో యు రిడ్యూస్ Right, madam. Now right, I am madam. Able to control.
Now I am able to control your
don't do anything, madam.
You don't do anything, madam. Don't do anything. Please
don't do anything.
Stop. Don't do anything.
Don't do anything.
Don't do anything in your computer. I will control.
Yes. Right now.
Yes. Right now.
You are in. Your email account page. Login to your mail.
Login to your mail, madam.
You can just close that window, sir. That is me. Window.
I am presenting. Okay, wait, madam. I will stop presenting.
Because you are already logged in. Directly, I will go to your.
But here you are operating.
Yes. In the same way you want to operate your mobile.
That is what you are conveying. If I want to insert photos, I got it, madam. Is that only doubt or any other doubt is there?
Sir, you invited for WhatsApp chat. So how do we need to create the WhatsApp URL to invite others to join in that group?
Okay, madam, these two I will explain in my end. Okay.
I hope now you understand how I can control your screen. See, right?
Yes, sir, by entering the password, you are assisting my system.
I am adding a question.
Added question.
And I am deleting.
So this will be helpful for one-to-one communication. Tomorrow. Please, normal time, day 10 from 10 a.m. onwards.
Please, you just ping me, madam.
We will connect. We will discuss all the doubts.
Remaining doubts, whatever the doubts you ask now. I will discuss now.
Okay.
Sir, apart from this, we can ask any other doubts, sir?
You can ask, madam.
Sir, personal doubt only, shall I ask you, sir?
Yes, yes, madam, you can go ahead.
Sir, after I thought you were attended that
madam, you are using two
FDP programs, sir.
Laptop, madam.
So in that
you close your
how
laptop
to...
you close your laptop Google Meet, use only mobile as of now. I think you got it.
Okay,
right.
Sir. Okay.
Because echo is coming, some disturbance is coming.
Okay.
Meanwhile, sir, who is there? You are. Madam, do you have any doubts? Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Right. Everyone now is joining. Please, if you have any doubts, use chat. Use chat. We have 9 more minutes. Just we will have just a discussion. I will discuss those doubts once the session start, because now everyone is joining. Please, everyone, can you hear me? Please use chat box. Can you hear me, everyone? Please use chat box. Put a message whether you are able to hear me or not. You use chat box, and you use chat box to put your doubts also. In 10 minutes, we will start the session. Madam, Priyadarshan, madam. Now you are using only one device, I think so. Now still two devices are showing. You can go ahead, madam. You are saying something. Okay, madam. Priyadarshan, madam, we will see. Next. Let us take Narasimha, sir. Sir, can you unmute yourself? P. Narasimha, sir. Are you able to hear us? Please unmute yourself. Or else we'll take Janisha. Janisha, madam. Please unmute yourself. If you have any doubts, just let us know. Or else you use the chat box, madam. Let us take Avijaya Malati, madam garu. Please. Can you unmute yourself? Do you have any doubts? As of now. I request the participant to put some messages in our WhatsApp group. Ask the participants to join. Now it is closing to 6. I request yes, everyone is joining now. So today Tirupati sir is having some other meeting, so I request to any one of the participant as a mediator for inland communication. So I request anyone is ready to be as a mediator for this session, please put in chat box. I request whoever having whoever using mobile phone with proper internet, and they can be a mediator. Just for inland communication, in between I can ask, is there a way to change the order of questions in the form? Yes, yes, madam. Janisha, madam, it is there. It is there. It is there. Today I will show. Simple drag and drop option is there.
you need to select that particular question and you need to move up and down where you want. That actually you can practice that. I will show it. Are you able to see my screen? Google Forms homepage I am opening. Google Forms page I am opening. Please use chat box. Are you able to see my screen? Are you able to see my screen? Please use chat box. No. Okay. I will start present screen. Your entire screen. Share. Now, madam. Now, are you able to see my screen? I started presenting my screen. Are you able to see my screen now? Priyadarshini madam, are you able to see my screen now? No, still no. Actually, I am presenting. I request other participants whether they are able to see my screen. I am in Google.
No, sir. Now only we are able to see, sir.
Yes, now we are able to see my Google Form homepage, right?
Yeah, start a new form and all that.
Sir, I request you to put some. You be my mediator. In between, I will be asking anything. You please respond. Meanwhile, I request everyone to put some message in our WhatsApp group. I request them to join, because in between, if they are asking, that will be difficult for us. It will disturb our session. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. So now I will go with one doubt, that is whether we can change the order of the question. Like, let us say some question is here. Untitled form. I am creating one question, question one is there, and I created one more question, that is question two, and I also created one more question, question three. You can have any question type here. For sample, I am showing. So right now we have three questions: question one, question two, question three. Okay. So we have three questions. Now I want to move this question three to the top. So here, when you move cursor over this question, in middle, you will be getting 3+3, yeah. Total 6 dots. Sir, are you able to see?
Yeah, clearly, sir.
When you click this, this is what, like a holding option.
Right.
You select, wherever you want, you can drop this, right? That's it. This is what movement of your questions. Today we will see, after including sections, multiple sections, we will see how to move the sections also. So this doubt is asked by Janisha madam. Now I hope you understood how to move the order of the question. Is it okay, madam? You please respond in chat. Janisha madam. Janisha madam. Did you get how to change the order of question in the form? I am asking the question for everyone who are in this meeting. Did you get how to change the order? Please, one by one, please respond. No, sir. Yes. Now opening. Yes. Got it. Please, everyone, try to respond so that I can know. Oh, thank you so much. All right. We will wait for a few minutes. Then we will go with the remaining question types and remaining settings. Those will be how to change the theme, color, and font text in the form, and how to insert image, how to insert YouTube video, how to use sections, and how to use sections based on student option or answer, that we will see today. Okay. And the most important is how to validate the student answer and authenticate.
That is what yesterday in my form I used mobile number authentication. If you are entering some mobile number, for a few participants it is showing your mobile number is not registered with us. Because okay. I have added this validation and authentication. I have already the mobile numbers of registered participants. I used a regular expression by which I can only allow the mobile numbers which are registered with me. So if anyone entering or if anyone filling this form who is not registered with us, they cannot proceed. One is validation, that means whether it is a mobile number or not, we are doing it. At the same time, we are authenticating also. Validation and authentication. For authenticating, you need to know regular expression. That I will touch up today little bit, because it is like a big thing, how to know, how to write regular expression, that is other thing. But we will see the response validation, few examples. Okay, so as of now, is it okay, sir? Please respond. Manokar sir just now joined. This is Janisha madam. Okay, Aarti madam just now joining. So we have almost 20 participants. As of now, 20 participants are joined.
21,
including me, 21. Okay,
now Pranita madam also joined.
Yes sir, you can go ahead, sir. You please, if anyone join, please inform us. If okay. anyone is chat putting any messages, you please inform me.
Okay.
I will put a message in WhatsApp.
Okay.
We'll wait for few minutes. It is already 6:02. Let us see. I am going to start this session. Please, everyone, join us.
Now 24 members have joined, sir.
Okay, sir. Who are there from my Spurti College? So let me know who is there in meeting from Spurti Engineering College, from my college. You use chat box. Tirupati sir is in another meeting. He will be joining late. Okay.
Aarti Yadav madam is present from your college.
Yes. Who else? A request to who are from Spurti Engineering College, please use chat whether you are present. Give your attendance in chat. Okay, Rajini madam already joined. She messaged in WhatsApp group. Oh, that's okay. So let's take a few participants, their doubts, what they have done. Let's go with I request to use chat. Who wants to speak? Whoever wants to speak, anything, doubts or something. Meanwhile, we are ready to hear. Please use chat if anyone wants to speak something, whether it is doubt or something. Or else, meanwhile, what I can do? Let me show anything for you. If it's possible.
and everyone is joining. Ramathirumugan.
Ramathirumugan is from my college, sir. He's my colleague.
Oh, nice, nice, sir. Sir, Ramathirumugan, sir, can you unmute yourself?
Yes. Yeah, yeah, tell me, sir.
Sir, how are you, sir? How was yesterday?
Fine, sir.
Have you created your first Google form?
Yes.
Are you able to hear us? We are unable to hear your voice.
Hello.
Yes, sir. You can go.
Hello. Yesterday I shared in WhatsApp group.
Okay, good, sir. Good.
And also today for some purpose I have created a Google form and shared with my colleague.
That's nice.
Collect some information.
Right, sir. Sir, when we use this Google form, when we practice, so that we will be getting more confident and we will be knowing to more options. Okay. Today, sir, I will start with one interesting form which will include all the question types and the sections. And some validation also. So with that, I can cover all the things. Then we can go with other extra things. Okay. So Manokar sir, our question is: it is possible? Is it possible to create others option in drop down? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Others option is there. Others option is always there wherever you have. You want to ask extra, like let us say, give me one example, branch. When you are asking branch, ECE, CSE, some kind of branches we can know. But some branches will be there which are some different name and different interdisciplinary branches. That we don't know. So for that purpose, in drop down or in MCQ, you include all the options, ECE, CSE and everything. And in the last, you will get some add other. Others option will be there. You just click on it. I will show one example, sir, lively. Sir, are you able to see my screen now?
No, sir. No.
Manokar, sir. You are not able to see my screen. Google form I have opened, sir. It is in sharing mode only. Are you able to see my screen now?
Poonachandra Reddy Wangara is presenting. That is only seeing.
Just it is presenting, it is showing.
Sir, it is visible, sir, for me.
Okay, right.
Branch. Untitled form is there.
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, branch I am asking, sir. In branch, I am using question type as checkbox. Now I am giving, question type as drop down. Option 1 is ECE, option 2 is CSE, option 3 is Tribly, option 4 is IT, and one more is MEC, and one more is Civil. Okay, and I don't know other branches what they are, I know only this, but there are other branches too in other colleges. Then here add option, what you will select? Other. Simply you keep other and make it as required. And description, go to section based on answer. Sir, here let me show the preview. Okay, I'm showing preview. So when we come here, branch, when we click other, actually we have to give one more option. When they click other, we need to ask the student to enter their actual branch. As of now, they clicked only other, but we don't know what is that other. For that, you see, sir, here other option, I clicked option 1, option 3, I am writing something, just I am submitting. But here what we are missing, we are not taking the branch of that student. What is that other? To do that, we have to use this option, sir. Go to section based on answer. If I click that, every option will have this section.
this question, this thing. Continue to next section, continue to next section. Please. Excuse me, they are joining. Everyone is joining now. Okay. So now here, sir, everything is fine. ECE, when they select, we need not to go any section. Simply, we need to go next section, next section, next section, next section, next section. When the question, when the student enter other, we need to go to other section. The other section which is not created till now, that will be here. Sir, this doubt, you please wait for just another 10 minutes, sir. Because if I am explaining this directly, you will get lot of confusion. Please wait for 10 minutes. For surely I will explain this, sir. Because right now, if I am using all this, now itself, I think most of them are having some confusion. What is this section and what is this continue to next section? Please bear with us just for 10 minutes. I will explain this, sir. But as of now, the general solution is putting other. But what is that other? We can use a section, sir. Okay? Is it okay, sir? Just wait.
Yes, sir.
Just wait for okay, 10 minutes. In the session, I will come to this doubt, sir. Okay? Because it is in the flow in my session. Okay?
Okay,
so,
sir.
Right. So now 30 participants are there. You tell me whether I should start or not. Now 30 participants are there. Let me see again in WhatsApp group. Okay. We'll start, sir. Anyhow, it is 6 to 12. Otherwise, we will be getting delay. So today, what we will do, sir, yesterday the assignment is, you need to prepare a Google form, your first Google form. It might be anything. And I requested everyone to install TeamViewer app for one-to-one communication. I think most of the participants are having some kind of confusion. What is this TeamViewer and how to use it? And what is this one-to-one interaction slot? It is very simple, sir. Our session will be between 6 to 8 only, where all the participants will join. This one-to-one interaction is simply for our doubts clarification. Let us say, Priyadarshini madam is having one kind of doubt. Now, madam, can you unmute yourself as of now? Because you are familiar with TeamViewer as of now. Priyadarshini madam? Can you unmute yourself? Okay, I will go. Okay, madam. Some echo is coming. You use chat box only, madam. Other can see. You use chat box. Okay.
Okay.
Responding. Sir, where I am? After installing TeamViewer app. After installing TeamViewer app. Madam, you mute yourself, madam.
Hearing.
Yes, you mute yourself, your side. Mute your audio. Okay. After installing TeamViewer app, you will be getting a screen. I will show directly now itself. TeamViewer. After installing, when you open this TeamViewer, you will be getting this kind of allow remote control, your ID and your password. And here you need to enter your partner ID. See, like how I am getting this your ID and password, when you open your TeamViewer, you will get your ID and password. You have to share that ID and password. I will enter that ID here and I will click connect. Then it will ask for password. When I click password, I will directly connect to their laptop. And now on, then onwards, I can control their screen. I can control their screen. So when you have any doubt tomorrow, in daytime, you just ping me so that we can connect with your screen with the help of this TeamViewer, and we can have a call. We can have a call on our mobile so that lively you can ask what is your doubt, and lively I can explain you, and at the same time I can control your screen. I can control your screen. Okay. So this is what the one-to-one interaction and TeamViewer usage. If everyone understood this, please use chart. Please use chart. Professor, please you let me know whether they are understood or not. Okay. Krishnan sir is having doubt. Okay sir, not a problem. You tomorrow you just ping me sir. In personal I will explain you. Okay, because this is not that much important, but it is important for doubts clarification. Okay. Okay, Vijay Malti madam. Okay, please everyone be active. Please use chat box. Whether you got it or not. What is TeamViewer and 1-to-1? I received only 3 responses. Please everyone use. Anil Kumar sir understood. Next please. Because we have 28. Yes. Okay, super. So now, today I will start with a new Google Form. The purpose is I want to take your Google Form links. Whatever you created your Google Forms, those links I require. To get those links, I want to create a Google Form. So let us start that Google Form and I will show you how to include other question types whichever possible in this particular form and how to change the theme, how to insert the header image. Sometime in these days when you are filling the application form or this registration form for any workshop or webinar, you will be finding a header image, their college logo or their webinar logo, some kind of image is there. In all Google Form pages, you will be getting that image in the first as a header. So how to insert those kind of images? We will see some kind of response validation. So can I go start Google Form? All right. Please, I request Professor Sir, please you be my moderator, because otherwise if someone is not responding, I don't know whether I am in line or not. I request only one professor to be my moderator, because today Tirupati Sir is in some other meeting. And remaining, please use chat box. This moderator has to look into that chart and parallelly giving input for me. Who will be the moderator? Please let me know. Aarti madam, are you in line?
Yes sir, tell me sir.
Madam, you be my mediator for this session. Whenever yes, I ask sir. Question, please you unmute yourself and you give response. Okay.
Okay, fine sir.
Thank you madam. So the first thank step is, so what is the first step? Everyone write down in chat. Madam, you please look into chart. Everyone write down the first step. What is the first step to go to my forms? I already logged into my Google browser. Already my account is there. Gmail account is there. So what is the next step to go to my page? Right. forms.google.com press enter. So now what is the next step to start a new form? New empty form. What is the next step? Madam, please check chart, because I cannot switch in between tabs. You please check whether they are
yes, giving correct response. They are giving the replies forms.google.com.
Yes, then next to start a new blank, to take a new blank form, what is the step?
Blank.
Yes.
Go
yes,
to blank.
Click blank. When you click this blank, automatically you will get a new form. But now I will give a small trick, small shortcut. That is forms.new. When you enter forms.new, after typing forms.new, when you enter, automatically you will be getting a new blank form. See, when you are practicing, when you are habituating to this Google Forms, you need not to go with the forms.google.com every time. Simply forms.new. For what purpose? To open new blank form. So what is that URL? Everyone please type in, use chat. What is that URL? How to, what is the shortcut? Yes, forms.new. Very good, very good. Right, forms.new. What is the title I want to give? Let us say this is for assignment. Let me give one assignment submission. Assignment submission. More precisely, webinar assignment submission. Webinar assignment submission. Form description. This is to collect. This is to collect. Please, all of you, you can use your Zoom option in your mobile. If you are not unable to see, please let me know in chat box. I will zoom it. So this is to collect links. Links of participants first Google Forms. So the title is webinar assignment submission. Webinar assignment submission form. This is to collect links of participants first to Google Form. Their first to Google Form. Just for the sake, I have written description. So untitled form. So now this is the title of the form. This is the this file name. File name. I have already clearly explained. So what is the first question? What is the first question? I already have your entire data. I already have your entire data. Again, I need not to ask you mail ID, everything. Simply, I am going with mobile number. Mobile number. Yesterday, few participants are having a problem with this mobile number. Today, I will rectify. Today, I will add those mobile number in this live session only. When I enter mobile number, forgive me, our TLC ID is joining. Let me admit him. Then I can proceed. Please give a 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Sir is joining. I need to admit him. Okay, we'll wait for 1 minute. Okay, I will go with the sessions in SAR, click join. So this is our webinar assignment submission form, and the first question is mobile number. So as we discussed, when you ask mobile number, automatically the question type will change to short answer and the response validation has been added. So now, as of now, I want to remove this. I want to make it as required. So right now, I request everyone to concentrate here. I want to use again response validation, but now I don't want this number. I want regular expression. And that regular expression must match with some pattern. What is that pattern? We will see now. With this kind of validation, I can give the authentication. Okay. Please give me 1 minute. Sir, just now I started the session, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, yes, you proceed.
Okay, sir. Thank you. So now.
Okay, no problem.
Now I want to give a pattern that is mobile numbers pattern, which allows only the numbers which are registered with us, Okay, for that, the procedure is, Aarti madam, can you see this screen, Excel? Aarti madam or anyone
ah yes sir I...
okay right
yes sir we can see
yes you can see my screen just give me a second so now I need the mobile numbers of participants mobile number of participants that I have in my database I will get those numbers and I will show how to create this pattern okay sorry just now I connected charger so now let me give before going to take my database I will give one example so this is the first column is mobile just I have written mobile so let us consider mobile number is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and some 6 7 8 and something some pattern is there let me use zoom option whether you are able to see the screen completely or not all right so now here I need to generate pattern so what is that pattern you will see so here 1 2 3 is one mobile number the student has to enter the student has to enter here in the response either this 1 2 3 either this 1 2 3 or 4 5 6 or 7 8 9 or 6 7 8 or 5 3 7 4 only these 6 that means either 1 2 3 either first number or second number or third number or fourth number or fifth number other than this you should not allow any number for that the pattern is this is from excel background if you want to write any formula you have to use equal symbol and what function I am going to use is concatenate automatically it will give you the spelling function name concatenate now for any function you have to use parenthesis open to open the function when you click this parenthesis automatically it will give the syntax it will give the syntax so here what is we I am going to do is I am going to take this 1 2 3 cell 1 2 3 cell see please look at my cursor I am clicking 1 2 3 A2 column then you use comma then you use comma then you write down a r symbol in a double quotes then close parenthesis okay I request everyone to write down this formula in chat box in your paper also formula is equal to concatenate parenthesis open a2 in my case it is a2 when you are doing in your excel sheet something will be there that is what your column of your mobile number comma double quotes r symbol where you will get this r symbol in your keyboard you have enter symbol right above the enter symbol or in some keyboards you will be using backspace always below the backspace also you will find out this r symbol okay is it okay please let me know Aarti madam are they responding in chat box
yes
okay after writing this just click enter what we get 1 2 3 r what is the pattern now either the number must be 1 2 3 r what we need to write 4 5 6 again you have to use this concatenate only for this second step for remaining step you need not to write just to use same concatenate and open parenthesis now you click this pattern previously created pattern don't click this number again just this click the previously created pattern that is b2 use comma and select the next number and again use comma and now you use double quote r symbol double quote close the parenthesis and enter. See, you can see the formula here. Equal to concatenate the cell number of previously created pattern, comma, the next number, next mobile number, comma, R symbol in between double quotes and parenthesis close. That's it. You need not to enter again and again. Just now you select this corner. This corner, I think everyone knows this option. You just select this and just drag to down the line until the last number. See, automatically I got a pattern. What is that pattern? Either 1, 2, 3. That means this pattern will allow either 1, 2, 3 or 4, 5, 6 or 7, 8, 9 or 6, 7, 8 or 5, 3, 7, 4. That's it. Other than these numbers, it will not accept other numbers. Okay, it will not accept other numbers. Now again use chat box whether you got this or not. Aarti madam, please respond. Please give response. Ah, yes.
Once again you repeat, they are asking.
Yes, okay, done. Okay, okay. Control Z. Okay. So is this first option is okay? Is this first option is okay? Concatenate this thing is okay, or I should start from starting? Please respond in chat box. Aarti madam will respond.
From here it is okay, sir. My sir, they want from the beginning.
Okay, done. Sir, as of now, you take it as a some algorithm. You write down as it is whatever I am explaining. Okay, don't try to understand the logic as of now. But we need logic every time. As of now, you just write down the points. Write down the points whatever I am explaining, and write down the functions. The first function is you have to write where you have to write, that you must understand. You create two columns. Everyone create two columns with first column name as mobile, second column name as pattern. In first column, you copy your entire mobile numbers which are with you, and in the pattern column, in the first cell, start writing a function equal symbol. Everyone keep writing. And use concatenate function, concatenate, concatenate, parenthesis open, and write down A2. As it is you write down, madam. Every participant write down as it is. A2, comma, double quotes open, use R symbol. Again double quotes and close the parenthesis. The procedure is start with empty excel sheet, create two columns, column A and column B. In column A and column B, the row, first row must be the name of that column, that is mobile and pattern. Then copy the mobile numbers in mobile column, and in pattern column, in the first cell, you have to write this equation. Is it okay? This first equation, is it okay? Don't confuse with this A2. Write as it is A2. Is it okay? Please use chat box. Madam, if you please respond.
What symbol is that, sir? They are asking.
Yes, just wait. Then I will show. If you ask doubts only, then we will get ideas to explain the concept more precisely. I am opening keyboard. Yes. Keyboard. Yes. Which one is clear? Are you able to see this screen, madam? Aarti madam?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, can you see this enter symbol and this backspace symbol here? Enter, and above the enter you have backspace symbol. And this above enter and beside this back symbol, you have this symbol. See, one vertical line. The same key, you can use it as a slash and this vertical. To get this vertical, you have to use shift. In some keyboards, it will come directly. In some keyboards, if you use shift, then you will get this vertical bar. This vertical bar, you need to enter. how to get that vertical bar, that is in from keyboard usage, how we are using keyboard, that is knowledge of keyboard usage. Madam, again you check the chat box, whoever asked this question, whether they got the point or not.
Yes sir, they got the point.
Yes, thank you so much. So now let us go back here. So the first C equation is completed. Press enter. Just press enter. After writing that equation, after closing parenthesis, don't touch any cell. Just press enter. Because when you are writing any function, if you are moving cursor here and there, automatically the function will change. Okay. And next, in the next cell, in pattern column, in second column, again you use equal symbol, concatenate. All of you write down concatenate and open parenthesis and write down this time B2. See, when I write B2, automatically the B2 cell is selected. Instead of writing B2, you can select that. Two ways you can do. See, B2. If I select, B2 is came. If I remove B2, if I write B2, then also that B2 is selected. So that is what I am telling. Comma. Now I want to write this A3. A3 is selected. Comma, again double quotes open, R symbol, double quotes close, and open parenthesis. If anyone will face this problem, any writing when you are writing this, if you are facing any problem, please tomorrow you ping me personally. We will connect with via TeamViewer. After writing this, press enter. Before going to enter, I request everyone to write this equation, whatever just now I written. Every participant, please write in chat box. Please write in chat box. Aarthi madam, please look into it. If they are writing properly, I can go with the next. Equal, concatenate, B2 comma A3 comma double quotes, R symbol and close. Okay, madam?
Yes, sir. You can carry.
Yes, thank you. Press enter. So now you select this cell, particular cell, and corner, right down corner, you will get some dot. When you move cursor to over there, automatically it will give some selection option. So when it gives selection option, use this left mouse and you drag to the last. So this is what your expression. What is this expression? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me, this one. You just copy this and keep it with you. Okay. Oh, let me show you. Word. Open. Sorry. Word I open. Control V. Just I copied. Yes, so this is what my pattern. To generate pattern, I have used this Excel and this function. Once it is done, you can close it. If you want for future purpose, you can save, otherwise you need not to save. So now I need to copy that pattern here. For that, just I am taking this pattern. But what you will get here generally, your mobile numbers. Okay, for that I already created this mobile pattern from your data. So this one, this big one, just I did those two steps. Just I selected the second cell and I dragged, then automatically this sequence is generated. Now I need to just copy this, and before placing into Google form, I'm keeping in somewhere place just for future reference. Okay, so I am closing this section, no need now. So now I will go with this first one for live example. I request 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 participants. I request 5 participants. Note down this sequence, because when sharing in online, you have to enter only these numbers. One is 1, 2, 3. Please note down 1, 2, 3 is one number. Allowed authenticated number is 1, 2, 3. And one more number is 4, 5, 6. And one more number is 7, 8, 9. And one more number is 6, 7, 8. And one more number is 5, 3, 7, 4. If you say okay, just I will copy that. Okay, I'm copying this. I'm moving here in the pattern. I just pasted. Paste. Okay, so it is required now. customer error text. So sorry, you were. So when you are going to give this text, whenever a student is entering other than these pattern, other than these numbers, then you are going to show this error, this message. Sorry, your number is not registered with us. Okay, done. So let me share this link to you in WhatsApp group. Just give a second. Send. I will get a copy. Just a copy. Because I'm not using this WhatsApp group in browser, because it is taking much internet. Just I want to share to my email ID and I will send in WhatsApp group. So lively, you can go with that. Once it is done, remaining it will take very less time. Only this is only very complex one. Remaining is very easy. Don't worry. Just be with us. Just be with me. I will explain clearly. Okay. Don't be tense or don't worry. Give a second. I am posting that link in WhatsApp group. Give a second. Yes, I got the number. Copy URL. Yes, I am sharing in the WhatsApp group. I request whoever using mobile phone, let me know in chat box. Let me know in chat box so that I will pick a few participants. Please let me know who are using mobile phone and who are ready to share their screen. In fact, if we are using laptop also, okay. Anyone. Please voluntarily, anyone, please respond in WhatsApp group, this chat group. The thing is, just now I shared a link in WhatsApp group using mobile. Sir, now you can share your screen, sir. I request who else using mobile phone? Only one responded. Please, this is interactive session. If all be silent, automatically we will get bored. Definitely, I am telling you, we will get bored. Please respond everyone, whoever using mobile phone. Because we should know, then and there itself, we should know how it looks, what is going on. Please, I request everyone to use chat box. Whoever using mobile phone, please put in chat box. Yes. Krishnan sir, thank you so much. In the right time you responded. Priyadarshini madam, I request Krishnan sir, please unmute yourself first. Krishnan sir, please unmute yourself first. Krishnan sir, can you hear us? Krishnan sir, you commented that you said you are using mobile phone. Please unmute yourself once. Please, anyone, Krishnan sir is having some problem, I think so. Please, others, please respond. Please don't make delay, because otherwise I will go in one direction. Simply I will explain what options are available. That will not give the correct impact. Okay. Yes, sir.
I'm having the mobile phone, sir.
Sir, can you share your screen now?
1 minute.
When you click on that your photo, sir, in your Google Meet that option in the screen, you will get entire screen. Share now. I will stop my screen as of now. And now you start sharing your screen, sir. We will see whether we are able to see your screen or not. We'll see. Is not it shared, sir?
I have the mobile phone and
you use or only mobile phone, sir. You use only mobile phone. In the mobile
No,
you need to show it, sir. In the mobile phone, actually, if you are using mobile, are you using mobile phone for meeting or laptop? Only laptop.
The laptop.
Then it is not possible, sir. I request other participants, please don't make delay. Already here, power gone. I said daily evening, we are getting rain here. Please, I request, I will go with this real-time example. Remaining, I will go one by one. Explain. Please, anyone who are using mobile phone, please do respond. Please use chat box. Let me check my chat box. Using mobile. Vedarshini, share the screen. Okay, anyone. Singaturai. Sir, can you unmute yourself first? Singaturai. Madam said using mobile. Sir, shall I? Yes, madam. Priyadarshini, madam, please go ahead. Please start sharing your screen. Priyadarshini, madam, please share the screen. If you are having the yes. Very thank you. Thank you so much, madam. Yes. Priyadarshini, madam, you use only mobile phone. Okay. You don't okay, that's okay, good. Now you go to your WhatsApp, madam. Our WhatsApp group. You go to our WhatsApp group. While sharing, you have to choose entire screen, madam. Again, madam, gone. Who else? Please. Shall I go with next topic? We'll go with the next thing, or shall I wait? Yes, madam is opening. Thank you, madam. Thank you. Okay, madam, you are using both mobile and laptop. Only present your either mobile or laptop. We are unable to see.
Sir, I'm using laptop only, sir. I shared the screen in laptop only, sir.
Your mobile is also started sharing, madam. That is the problem.
Okay, sir, I will quit my mobile.
Okay. No, not a problem. Now, yes, you close your mobile, just use laptop. Yes. So now, madam, she is in our group. Madam, you open that link. Thank you. Right. Now you can see the impact, what we have done. Madam is opening our form. Madam, try to enter some number. Double one. Some number. Now try to submit. Sorry, your number is not registered with us. Right? So now you try, madam. What is the valid number? What is the authenticated number we have created in the pattern? One is 1, 2, 3. Yes. 1, 2, no, madam. Only 1, 2, 3. Either 1, 2, 3 it will take, or either it will take 4, 5, 6, or either it will take 7, 8, 9. For example, I consider only 3 digit, but you can have any digit. Now you enter submit. See, now it is taking. I hope everyone got this. I hope everyone understood this authentication. With the single question, mobile number, if you are having mobile database, you can authenticate your form. I request every one of you use chat box, whether you got it or not. Then I will quickly go to the next section. Madam, you can stop your presenting. Priyadarshini, madam, you can stop. I request everyone to put comment whether you got it or not. Yes. I request everyone. Got it, sir. Got it. Thank you so much. So here power gone. I will quickly go through the next. So I am presenting. I am using your entire screen. Share. Aarthi madam, can you see my screen, Google Forms screen?
Yes sir.
Thank you so much. So now, instead of this pattern I have generated for understanding purpose, I am going to take this mobile number pattern. Control C. I have generated this pattern in the same manner what we did till now. So I am going here, I am pasting here. Okay, so randomly I will go with other question. So what yesterday we didn't covered few questions, we'll choose those questions now. The first question we have covered, short answer we covered. Paragraph is similar to short answer, same thing, but they can enter multiple lines, so much data, so much text. And other thing is multiple choice we have covered. Check boxes we have covered. Check boxes, let me use this check boxes. So please select the checklist. What kind of checklist I am going to ask you is, have you installed TeamViewer? Have you installed TeamViewer? That is what first checklist I want. And have you created your first form, and next one is have you filled the 1-to-1 slot form, and one more is so please give any suggestion. Just for sample I am giving this. I will change this, but for understanding purpose I am keeping all this. Please give any suggestion. I will put one other thing. Please select the checklist form. Do you have doubts? Anything you can write down here. Just I am giving one examples. Do you have doubts? Okay, so this will be the checkbox. I am making it as required. So whenever the question comes, you have to select which are appropriate for you, which are suitable for you. If you are installed TeamViewer, you have to check this. And if you are done with your first form, you have to check this. Okay. So let me show the preview. So if you click preview, so you are going to write your mobile number 123 other than 123. Oh, okay, 123. Because now I have changed the pattern. See how I changed the pattern. It is not showing. You have to give proper number, which registered. Okay, now it is taking this number because this number is registered with us. Okay, yesterday if you are facing problem here, because the reason is I don't have those numbers in my pattern. That is the only thing, nothing other than that. So now please select the checklist. Have you installed TeamViewer? Yes. Have you created your first form? Yes. Have you filled the 1-to-1 slot form? Yes. Do you have doubts? Yes. If someone is not yet done this slot, they should not select this. If someone not yet to install this TeamViewer, they should not select this. So now I think you understood what is the importance of checklist. The checkbox itself, it is mentioning checklist. Okay. So next I am going with the next question. Here I will start how to use section. Okay. It is now 7. I will take 1 hour. Okay. I will explain the remaining thing. So now the question is, are you able to complete the assignment today? Just I am asking sample question for understanding purpose only. One option is yes, automatically it is giving. See options, it is automatically giving no, and one more is maybe, and one more is pakka cannot. One more is can't. Sorry, cannot. Okay. So one is yes, one is no, and one is maybe, and one is cannot. Okay. So I'm making it is required. I'm making it is required. So now here onwards, I want to use sections. So my intention is, whenever this question is there in the form, are you able to complete the assignment today? I am taking my example. No, I want to say answer no. Are you able to complete the assignment today? No. When they click no, what kind of information I required? May I know the reason? May I know the reason? Please tell us. That kind of question I need to ask. And in case if they click yes, are you able to complete the assignment today? That is the question. When they answer yes, then what should be the next section? We need to provide the section where he can upload his assignment. He can upload his assignment. Okay. So for that, see, in the vertical bar, last point is add section. Two horizontal boxes, add section. If I click add section, I am giving untitled section. This is for yes. This is for yes answer. And I am going to use one more section. And this is for no. This is for no. This is for no. And again, I want to select one more section. Every section is having untitled section. One more is joining now. Admit. So every section is having a name. Untitled section. I want to give this is for cannot or maybe. Maybe. And one more. And one more section I am going to add. One more section I am going to add. And that name is as cannot. Cannot. Okay. So now go to yes. Go to yes. And go to no. And go to maybe. And go to cannot. So now the next step is select the question for which you want to add sections, for which you want to add sections based on the student respond, based on the user respond. For that, go to this three dots in the down right side. Go to section based on answer. Go to section based on answer. Select that. Once the moment you click this go to section based on answer, automatically you are getting some kind of column, some kind of drop down menu. Beside every option. Okay. So now, if I click yes, where should I want to go? See, you can see all the sections in the form. I want to go to section yes. And when I click no, where I want to go? I want to go to no section. If the user selected maybe, then I want to go to maybe. If the student selected cannot, then also I want to go to cannot. Okay. For no and cannot, you can go to a common section, because after knowing the participant is selected no or cannot, what is the next information we want to expect? What is the reason? Generally, we will ask what is the reason. Okay. So I am removing this or let it be there only. Okay. I request every participant to put your comment, put your response in chat box, whether you are following this or not. Until now. Aarthi madam, you please respond.
Okay. Participants are able to understand, sir.
Yes, okay. So now go to yes section. Go to yes section. Okay, when the participant said, okay, I am ready to complete my assignment by today, then what we need to ask? Go to this section, select that section. This is very important, because I need to add the question in this particular section. Go to plus. When you click plus, a question will be added to this particular section called yes. And what should I ask? Please upload or please provide link. What kind of link? Your Google form link. Please provide your Google form link. I am explaining these sections with the help of this example. You can apply for anything. The moment I used a word link in the question, automatically the response validation is added, that is text and that must be a URL. So this is true only. You need not to remove this. But the one thing is you need to make required. Because once he said yes, you must consider his assignment, the Google Form link. And here itself, I want to explain one more question type. If you click again, plus. Okay, the next question is added in this particular yes section only. Now the next question is, please upload your form in PDF. I will explain today how you can generate PDF. If time permits, I will explain that. But what you need to do here, what is our requirement? I want to get the PDF, of the particular participant Google form. For that, the question type must be file upload. Okay, again I am going. The question type must be file upload. The moment when I click file upload, you will be getting some kind of message, that is, let respondents upload files to drive. That means whatever the files they are going to upload, those files will be moved to or uploaded to your particular drive, which is linked with your Gmail account in the starting with which you have logged into. So select continue. Then the question will come. Okay, the question is, please upload your form in PDF. And the question type is file upload, and you have some kind of settings. Let us see what are those. Allow only specific file types. Yes, I want only PDF. I want only PDF. For that, you must enable this. The moment when I enable this option, it is showing some kind of types. What are the type of the file? Okay, you are having different types of files. One is document type, one is spreadsheet, one is PDF, image type, video type, audio type. Okay, any kind of presentation also they can upload. Okay, but here what is our requirement? Our requirement is PDF. So select PDF. When you select this kind of setting, you are not allowing that particular participant to upload any other kind of document, any kind of file. We are allowing him to enter only PDF. Other than PDF, he cannot upload any other file type. So now next, what is the next setting? Maximum number of files. If you beside this, you are having a drop down option. If you click that drop down option, as of now they are given three options. Either they can upload one, PDF, or they can upload 5 PDF, or they can upload 10 PDF. Okay. Generally, you can use this file upload option when you are conducting an online exam. Of course, it will be open book exam only. After giving questions to your students, they will be writing the answers on papers, and they will take the photo. Or they will, after taking their photos, they can make into PDF, then they can upload here. So that is what the application of file upload. Our scenario I explained, but you can apply anywhere. Okay. So now I am selecting only one, because you are getting only one PDF, one form, one PDF. Maximum file size, you can select the maximum file size also. Generally PDF size will be only 1 MB. Generally you will get 1 MB only, because your PDF is going to have only text. It will be less than 1 MB only. But safe side, I am keeping 10 MB. For safe side, I am keeping 10 MB. Maximum file size. What do you mean by maximum file size? If student is entering a PDF which is above 10 MB, it will not allow. It will allow only the PDFs which are less than 10 MB. The moment when I click this large size, 1 MB or 10 MB, 1 MB is the least size. If I select this 10 MB, you must know, let us say I want to share this Google form to only 60 students. 60 students means not a problem, more than sufficient data is there. That is, this form can accept up to 1 GB. Okay, within 1 GB you can get, you can accept those data. But for safe side, you can increase this size also. Where you will get that size? here 1 GB maximum size of files uploaded. Once again I will explain this. After selecting this maximum file size, go to this change setting. When you click this change setting, we will be directed to our general settings. We already seen in general settings, in the down, maximum size of all files uploaded. Okay, here this maximum file size is only one file size. In this setting, we are setting the size of entire responses. Save side you convert into 10 GB, save side you make it as 10 GB save. And here one doubt will arise, like yesterday after getting student responses, okay, we have submitted, we have shared this Google form to our students, like in our example I shared to you. After upload, you uploaded your PDFs, but where I will get this PDF again? Previously we used spreadsheet to get the responses, text responses, but this PDF documents, where it will go? In the starting only it says, what it is saying, your data is going to store in your drive. Okay, so your data is where it is, your data, it is in your drive. Go to your drive and there you will find under webinar, assignment, submission, responses, you will get those PDFs. Okay, the title will be as it is of our Google form. Okay, so and you, I want to make it as required. As of now, if anyone is having doubt, you use chat box. Aarthi madam, please let me know.
Okay sir,
I request everyone to use chat box if you have any doubt. We will go with live if you respond quickly, otherwise I will go like this only. Please. Madam, are they responding?
Yes sir.
What they are saying, is it okay? Shall I go with next?
Yeah, proceed sir.
Okay. Madam, while we are practicing, we will come to know, we will most of the times we will learn from the mistakes only. Okay. So now we covered question type. Let me show. I don't want to disturb this. Let it be file upload. Don't disturb. So this is the yes section. I will go to no section. I want to click no. Once I click no, then only press plus symbol, then only the question will be added to this particular section. The next question, when the user says no, I am not ready to submit today, then I what is the reason? Simply I can ask, may I know the reason? Anything, just I am giving example how you can use these sections. May I know the reason? Just question, I am asking question. Okay, so here short answer, or you can put paragraph, it will give other reason. Okay, I am making it as required. Okay, so here anyhow I am this type. We covered short answer, we covered paragraph, we covered multiple choice, we covered checkboxes, drop down, file upload also we completed. And linear scale, I will use this linear scale in the last section, cannot. Okay, and multiple choice grid, this is feedback form. I will share the feedback form. You will come to know what is multiple choice grid. The assignment is, today's assignment is, try to create a Google form including this multiple choice grid. Yourself, you try these two, multiple choice grid and checkbox grid. I will give hint for this particular two options. We already know date. So let me use date here itself. You can ask like this, if not today, when can you submit? Please, I am writing this text for only example. When can you submit? So we are asking a date, so then you can use this date. So if they when they come to here no, they will give the reason. Then we are asking, if not today, when can you submit? Make it as required. See, generally we should not make it as required, but here I already mentioned four options: yes, no, maybe, cannot. I asked the question today, are you able to submit or not? No means some other day you can. What is the date we are asking? what is that day we are asking. Okay, so I will go with maybe. So maybe I'm adding a question here. I will use this linear scale. Generally, linear scale we are using for feedback or anything, any question which is having some scale 1 to 5. If you want to give a star, how much stars you want to give? Generally, in commercial online sites, we will be seeing for products in the review, you will be having 5 star. Out of 5 star, how many stars you want to give? So maybe. So I want to ask question: how many points you want to give us? It is not appropriate for this maybe option. Just I am showing, I am covering all the question types. That is my motto. Okay, that is my intention. So here you can give 0 or 1. Let me put 0 also, and you will be having up to 10. 5 is enough. 0 to 5 is good enough. Okay, you can label these options. 0 is poor, and 5 is, let it be anything, very good or excellent. Okay, poor, excellent, and make it as required. So this is what your linear scale. Okay, next, cannot. For cannot, what we have to add? We covered everything except these two. I want the participants use chart box which question you want to add here. Let us go with anything, because I covered everything. If you want these two, please pick anyone. I will go with anything. Aarti madam, are they entering in chart box anything, or shall I proceed?
Till now no one responded, sir.
Okay, so let me think about this multiple. No, I will give it to you only. You have to, today you have to create a Google form, or tomorrow to include these two options. I clearly mentioned this above multiple choice and check boxes are one dimensional questions. This multiple choice grid and checkbox grid, these two are same as these two, but only the dimension is two. Two dimensional questions these are. Okay, I will give some hint. So when they say cannot, please give suggestions to improve hands-on session. Because they said cannot, we need to know the answer. Please give suggestions to improve hands-on session. Or you can ask again, may I know the reason? Okay, see, automatically it is changed to paragraph, because I kept a word suggestions. This is what artificial intelligence of Google. When I say suggestions plural, then automatically it changed to paragraph. Okay, because it is multiple line. Okay, then click required. So someone is joining. Let me join them. Okay, now I will go with preview. Just will close this. Okay, so mobile number 9573993994, and I need to check anything here. And see, now onwards you see here, what is the question here? Are you able to complete the assignment today? I am able to see only this question. No other sections right now I am not able to see. If I click yes and click next, the form is directed to yes section. Please provide your Google form link. We already know how to get the link. Copy there and paste here and click add file. You can submit your file. Or if you are selecting the next option, like no, if you are saying no, now the form is redirecting to other section, no section. May I know the reason? If not today, when can you submit? If I go again back, if I choose other option like maybe, then I click next, I am redirecting to maybe. How many points you want to give us? And if I go back again, if I select cannot, next, it is going to cannot. For demonstrating you only, I am going back and forth. Generally, any participant will not go like this. After, are you able to complete this assignment today? He will choose any one of it like this. Let me say no or maybe. Then he will click next. Again, he don't go to back because he already chosen his option as no. Now he will answer this. How many points you want to give us? Let me say 0. Then you click next. Then you click next. Automatically it is submitted. And I ask, please give suggestions to improve hands-on session. Yes. This is what the mistake we have done. After selecting maybe section, if I click next, where should I go? Submit. I should not go to cannot section. Okay. So let me see that setting. With that, we can close this settings with the section option. Okay. Right. So when you select this yes section, in the down of this section, you are having continue to next section. Continue to next section. After this section, what is that section? Yes. Where you want to go? In fact, we need to go submit form. That you need to enter. Here also, continue to next section. It is going to maybe. This no section is going to maybe, but the no section should go to submit form. And this maybe section also should go to submit form. Just before we have seen, maybe after giving 0, I clicked next. Where I went? I gone to can't section. But where should I go? In fact, submit, direct final stage. For that, you need to change this option. Continue to next section. Option is there by default. You need to change to submit form. So anyhow, this is the last section. Automatically, it will go to submit only. Because no other section is here. This is all about sections. Please, I request the participants use chat box. Whether you got it or not. This sections. How to use sections. While you practice, you will get more doubts. That tomorrow, we will... I will explain you, but as of now, did you get it or not? Please use chat box. Aarthi madam, please respond. It is 7:17. We have much time. I will explain the remaining. Aarthi madam, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Are they responding?
Everyone got it, but Thirumurugan sir has doubt. Could you please explain how to create section once again?
What is that question, madam?
Could you please explain how to create sections?
Acha, sections. Okay, done. Just wait. Sir, after opening the form, you have the vertical bar. Okay. In vertical bar, the last option is add section, sir. Last option is add section. And sir, here you need to important key point is there, sir. Actually,
okay.
Before entering section, you must know where you want to enter your section. Let me explain you once again. Sir, here I have a question, sir. Please give suggestions to improve hands-on. I am in this particular section. Now I want a section to create. Down this question. Please give suggestion question is there, na? After I want to include a section. For that, first you need to select that question. Then you select section. Automatically one section will be added down the question.
Now it is clear, sir.
Generally what the mistake we will do is our cursor, our selection will be in somewhere in our Google form. Simply we will select section, but we will confuse where it is gone. We are selecting, but it is not reflecting. That means you must know the cursor position where you are right now.
Okay, sir.
And sir, anyhow, you ask a doubt. This untitled section I don't want. When I don't want any section, how to delete it? Sir, this one, sir. If you select these three dots, you will have duplicate section. Like how move we section. Have duplicate question option, you will have duplicate section also.
Okay.
And move the section. One participant asked how to move the questions. I said you have move option for sections also. Right?
Okay.
So you can use this move section. I will explain one by one. And merge with above. Merge with above is simple. If you're already having a section and you already having other section questions, if you want to include these questions to above section, you want not to be not to include all the questions. Actually, you want all the questions in one section, then you can use this merge with above. Okay. And
okay.
Now I don't want this section. I want to delete this section. I selected delete. Let us see this option. How to move? How to move? Move section. See, when you click this move, automatically it is opening a window where you can move with the help of this arrow buttons. My intention is the maybe must come after yes. The maybe section must come after yes. Then simply I go to maybe and click up arrow. Automatically, okay. Maybe is gone up and no came down. Or otherwise, okay. You can use this option also. Drag, drop, drag and drop. Select and drop.
Okay.
This is also very easy. Okay?
Okay.
Right. This is moving option. Next. What are the other options? Duplicate. Duplicate is very simple like question. Okay? With this, we done with the, this add section.
Add section.
Yes. Yeah. I want to include this YouTube link for that. Let me use any one section. In one particular section, I want to in the starting itself. In the starting itself, I want to include a question. So I need to select any question in that particular section. I used this question. Just I'm clicking this. Ante. Just I'm selecting this question. Now use this add video option. When you click, the moment you click add video, you are asked to enter YouTube search. So I want to use very simple, what is that, day 2 or anything I will enter, just wait. So day 1, enter. I'm searching for something, or else Google Forms. Like this you have to search any YouTube what you required, then select that link and in the down select option. The moment you select, automatically that video is added here. Here you have two kind of option. You can change the size of this YouTube icon, I mean YouTube video. Select that you will be getting a select option with corners with selection option. If you want the size resizing, you can decrease or you can increase. Okay, I want this much size, so I'm increasing to this much. And one more option is there. Let us say my size is only this much. But I want this in center alignment. How to change the alignment? See, if I click on that YouTube link, YouTube whatever icon, thumbnail. Then you will have this kind of selection, resizing selection. The moment I click outside, you will get a top corner three dots. Click that three dots, you will have alignment option, remove option, change the video option. So I am using center alignment. So automatically it is coming under middle. Okay, in middle. So this is what YouTube. And I want to add an image. I want to add an image. Not this header image, general image. So I want to insert image. Let me show one example. Okay, somewhere it is there in section 1. I am in question 2. In section 1, I am in question 2. I am clicking this add image. Please don't confuse. If you click this add image, this image is not going to add into this particular question. It is adding into this particular section. For that purpose, I randomly used one of the question in that particular section. Okay, so click add image. It is asking upload option. Let me choose upload option and upload. Open. Then automatically our image is uploading to our Google form. Yes, again you will be having same thing, resizing option, center alignment. Anyhow, it is very good enough, so no need of center alignment. Okay, so now you can give image title anything you can give. Here I am giving random examples. Okay, you can apply for any Google form. Okay, so we are done with this. And I want to include any text, any subtitle, you select it. So where it is added, see right now where it is added, I need to check it because my cursor, where it is, I don't know. Untitled untitled title. You then I want to give assignment. Assignment section or something you can write on. Let me give it proper title. This is for assignment submission. Just I am showing how you can use this title. Don't confuse with this text. You can write down your proper full grammatical statement when you are creating your Google form. For example, for the sake I am using description. Please give real response or genuine response, something. Okay, something you can write down. So this thing, where I want this question, this particular text, I want this particular section, particular text in the starting, let me reduce this screen. Okay, someone is joining. 726. Okay, so now I want this particular text. See, the moment when move my cursor over here, automatically it is giving this holding option. You just click left side in the mouse to select, just you move it is up actually where you want. So I want in the starting, so I am moving it towards upside and placing there. Okay, so we are done with sections. Inserting video, inserting image as a section, like separate image, and inserting text, general heading, and this option import question you need not to use now itself. In future, after you are habituated to creating more forms, then you will come to know this import option. We already seen this place option. Okay, so let me show the preview. Mobile number 9573993994. Mobile number is given. See, you can see the text here. This is for assignment submission. Please give real response. So I asked mobile number. I entered mobile number. I checked the checklist, whatever applied for me, something. Then I have seen greetings for information. You can put any kind of image which you want if required. Then they can go through this video. Generally, we didn't create any title. We didn't write any title for this. You can write title. How you have written title for this image, in the same way you can write title for this YouTube video also. Like mentioning, please watch the video before going to further. Something like that, because you can use this option for our student when you are giving some kind of assignment, open book exams kind of thing. Then are you able to complete the assignment today? Now we changed that auto, go to section thing. Previously we did a mistake. So now you see, if I click yes, if I click next, it is asking something. It is asking, definitely it is asking link. I am giving something link over here. It is link is there. It will allow only links. Okay. Something I need to add a file. I need to upload it. PDF. It is asking only PDF. Okay. One PDF I have selected. Add more files, because you can add more files. But when you add more files, it will not consider, because we selected only one file over there. Okay. Just upload. So if you select upload, so it is uploaded here. Just submit. So now form is submitted. One student selected yes and he submitted his response. Now it is turned to other response. Mobile number, again I am using same number, but here I cannot restrict. If some students are using other numbers, that thing we cannot restrict here, but you can do that. You can do that with the help of script editor. With the help of script editor, that is like development, code developers can do that. Okay, please select the checklist. Again, some other person selected too, and he selected this time maybe next. Now he got his section particularly. See, now the moment maybe, after maybe, directly submit his option is there, but earlier we have next option because we forgot to change that setting. So now I selected 2 rating or 0 rating and click submit. So now the form is submitted. Okay, I hope I covered all these sections or types or options what are available in this vertical bar. I covered everything. The only thing I didn't cover is you can add an image in question also, in options also. Please, everyone, please observe. I selected this particular question. this particular question. The moment when I move my cursor over options, see, over option yes, it is giving image option, add image. See here, no, for no option it is showing, for maybe option, for every option it is showing a add image option. Similarly, if I move cursor over the question also, it is showing add image option. Generally, this add image option we are going to use in quizzes. We are going to use in quizzes. That we will see tomorrow. That we will see tomorrow. Except that we covered all question types except two, that is for assignment. And we covered all the this vertical section, vertical panel is having, that all options we have seen. Now, how to change the theme color? See, when I open this, when I click submit another response, the color, it is very simple color, it is there, background or white is there, and text is also very simple. Some kind of settings you want, then how to do that? Then how to do that? I think everyone is following me. Please use chat box. If you say yes, I will go to this next topic. Now time is 7:30. We have good enough time. I will go with the next topic. Please use chat box. Are you following me? Aarti madam or anyone, please give response. Because I cannot go back and every time check.
Sir, there are 2-3 doubts, sir.
Yes, excellent. If you have doubts, that is good. They are following. What are the doubts?
Rima Malini madam, she asked how to drag, sir. Please repeat it. And Satish sir, he said, what happens when we submit if the section is not at the end of the form?
If the section, let me take first doubt. The first doubt, okay, is how to drag the sections or how to drag the question. How to drag the sections or how to drag the question? Questions or section? That clarity I need.
Sir, only here it is mentioned how to drag. Sir,
please.
It is an image or it is a question? We don't. Maybe it is the question.
Question.
Ma'am has written.
Okay, simple, madam. You just move over cursor. Let me give one example, madam. Here, let me consider one question here. You don't look at screen as of now. Just be there. You don't look at the screen. I am not explaining anything. Just don't look at the screen. Okay. So let us look at this option, madam. When I open my this form, first I have given a title, then I have given a subtitle, then I have asked mobile number, then I am asking a question. Are you able to complete the assignment today? If I ask this question after this mobile number itself, if the person enter yes, automatically I am going to section 2. If the person is selecting no, I am going to section 3. If the person is selecting maybe, I am going to section 4. And if he is selecting cannot, then I am going to section. But I will not go to next questions. So in this case, what you want to do? I don't want this question in the starting. This should be at the end. For that, you just move over your cursor. Move your cursor over that particular question in the middle. The icon is changing. Please look on the screen. Please look at the screen. The icon is changed, madam. Can you able to see? Everyone, please do respond. Generally, the cursor will be arrow. The cursor will be arrow. The moment when you move that cursor over that particular question, that arrow icon will be changed to one holding option. Generally, we will be finding this kind of thing in any documenting. Madam, are they responding? They got it or not?
Yes, sir.
Once you got that icon, just if you are using mouse, left click. Always in your laptop touch pad, okay, or if you are using mouse also, you use left click. The moment when you click left, that means you are selected, you are holding that. So now you want to move it to down, where in the section one itself, in the section one, I want to move it to down. So I crossed greetings, I don't want after this. I crossed untitled video after this. Anything is there? Oh no, I am going to next section. Then what is the place I need to place here? After this video. So you stop here and leave that left click. leave that left click. The moment you leave that left click, it is placed. It is placed. It is placed. Madam, what is the madam name who asked this question? Please let me know.
Hema Malini, madam.
Hema Malini, madam. Now, are you able to do this moving the question?
She understood, sir.
Understood, right? Now, what is the next question, madam? Next question, you said something.
What happens when we submit if the section is not at the end of form?
The section is not it. Particularly, I didn't understand, but okay. Sir,
submit section if not available, maybe at the end of the form.
In fact, submit form, you never, submit section, you never see in the form. Submit is by default, it will be there. See, the submit form option is there, na? This one you will not see anywhere. But you can change the confirmation message. You can change the confirmation message that we already seen in the settings option, in the presentation option. Confirmation message will appear in submit form. The only thing available in submission form is, submit section is confirmation message. If you want to do anything with confirmation message, go to settings, go to presentation and give your present confirmation message over here. Okay. Still, if you have any doubt, please you ping me personally, sir. We will connect with the team viewer. I will control your screen remotely. Then you will clearly understand. Okay, we will go with next. Other than this, any questions are there, madam? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Other than this, any questions are there?
Sir, it is like commerce HOD, kindly send the recordings of day 2 webinar as you did it for day 1. This yes, will help us to continue.
Yes, yes.
More than this, there are no questions.
Okay, done. I am recording the session. I will be sending. Okay, let us move to settings of our this theme and color and font style. For this, right side, top side, beside preview option, left side, you will get customized theme. Some artistic pattern icon will be there with the name customize. With the name customized theme beside this preview option, you just click that customized theme. The moment when you click that customized theme, you will be getting a short window theme option. What are the settings are available? You can change, you can insert header image, you can change the theme color, you can change the background color, and you can change the font. Generally, it will be basic. Here you provided only four kind of fonts. You can use anything you want. Okay. Let me check with other. See, the moment when I click the other option, automatically the questions are changing. Not options. The main headings, main question headings or section headings. You can see they are changing. Look at the text. I am changing. There they are changing. Okay. So this is one example. One how to change font. And next, don't use the theme color and background color if you are choosing header. If you want to include any image as a header, don't choose theme color and background color. Automatically Google will give the supporting, the best suitable color. It will automatically select the best suitable theme color and best suitable background color. After that, if you want any changes, you can do that. When this option is applicable, this setting, I am giving a suggestion. You can do anything. My suggestion is, if you want to use a header image, don't select theme color and background color. Automatically it will be selected. So let us go with this option, header, choose image. Again, the moment when I click choose image, it is asking me to upload, or I can use already available arts. So let me check this. If I select this and insert option is there, down this insert. The moment when I click insert, it is inserted and it is reflected at the header. See, the moment I inserted this image, automatically background color is changed and the theme color is also changed. See, you can see the theme color is become yellow because the more yellow is there in the image, and lightly orange color is set as a background color. Automatically it is giving. If you want any changes, you can do right now. Now you can do. I don't want that. You can do, go with blue. You can go with this, or you can go with pink. Okay. So automatically it will give. Afterwards you can change. Okay. So this is one more option. So I don't want this image. I don't want this image. Again, click this, close, choose image. I want a separate image of my college logo or something else. Then you have to choose for upload. Upload. The last option is photos. This photos is your Google photos. Your Google photos. Who are using this Google product, they will know this photos. As of now, you don't need. Go to upload option. Select browse. The moment when I select browse, you will be directed to this option. Readily, you, before that, you readily you be ready with your that photo. Select that and open. Please take care of the dimensions. Please take care of the dimensions. Okay. So I have selected. Sometimes it will not shown here because of this internet or some settings. You just done. You click done. Then you can see. You can see. If it is not properly setted, you can remove that. So I have selected. It is loading. Header is loading. It is loaded. Now it is reflected here. All changes saved in drive. So now it is selected here. Okay, because intentionally this color is okay, good. Okay, so in this way you can add header image, you can change theme color, you can change background color, you can change this font style. Okay, so this is the thing I want to convey. This thing we covered, preview we have covered, and we covered settings, three kind of settings. And we covered how to add questions and everything. And we covered the name of the title and what is this title. And we have seen responses a little bit. Today we will see more with one example I will show you. And if is anything is left over here, nothing is left over. We have seen send option also. When you click send option, you can send this form with mail. If you have mail IDs, you can mail them. And you can include that particular form in mail itself. Or you can go with link. Copy that link. Once you get copy of it, you copy here and wherever you require, you paste. Wherever you require, you paste. Okay. And this embed option, this is more advanced. If your time permits, I will explain you. But as of now, you don't need this kind of option. This copy and you paste in your WhatsApp, like we did yesterday, and we are doing. This is send option. And one more option is there. This is like main settings. More option. Besides send, more option. One is undo. You need not to go every time here. Just Ctrl Z is enough. If you click Ctrl Z, that is undo only. Make a copy. That means, let me give one example. Whenever you are creating any Google form for official purpose, for any event purpose, safe side, you make a copy. That's it. It is a duplicate. How we have duplicate question, duplicate section, duplicate form is also there. It is some kind of hierarchy, you can see, you can observe. If you click make a copy, the entire Google form, one copy will be there with the name copy of webinar assignment submission with that name, file name. And move to trash. The moment when you click move to trash, it is gone. It is gone. Okay. Get pre-filled link. Yesterday madam has asked one doubt, but as of now, for basics, you don't need this. But when you are practicing, when you are getting more kind of scenarios, then you will have to use this. Yesterday, one participant asked, how to get the PDF? Okay, how to get the PDF? In this form itself, I said, after creating your Google form, take a PDF, make it a PDF and upload here. So for that, you use this print option. When I click the print option, it is preparing print. It is preparing to print. Down the line, you can see. So you are getting the print. But you need some kind of settings here. Everyone may not get the save as PDF option. Few will be getting. For that, you need to make some changes. The layout is landscape. I want to make it a portrait. If you want more kind of settings, you can do more kind of settings also. Okay. Then you can see what are the pages you are getting here. See how we are getting. Okay. And click save. When you click save, it is asking a director or director where you want to save. Let us choose desktop as of now. Save. So if I click save, it is saved to desktop. Let me go to desktop. See, here it is, webinar assignments form. I am opening it. The moment when I open that PDF, it is asking something because I recently updated this one. Next. Recently updated this form. That is the reason it is asking. Okay. So now see, you can see the form. Now can you respond in chat? What is the best usage best usage of this print option. Just for example, for uploading purpose, I asked PDF, but you have a wonderful requirement of this option. Please let me know in chat box where you can use this, where you can use this PDF after creating a Google form. If you are creating a PDF, what is the advantage? Please respond in chat box. Please everyone use chat box. Very informative session, but we need more practice. Yes, sir. I think Prabhakaran. Sir, practice session, you can tomorrow, please ping me personally. The entire day I will be available. With the help of TeamViewer, I will explain, I will help you point to point where you practice, and I will help you. Okay. So the point is, if you are using this print option, let me give one scenario. I want to conduct a quiz. I want to conduct a quiz for my students. Okay. In online. My plan was online. But suddenly some unexpected reasons that computer lab is not working properly. Some power off option is there. Some net problem is there. But I need to conduct exam. What is the situation? What is the solution? Simple. You take print of 60 copies or 50 copies. You go with offline exam. You go with offline exam. You need not to set the question paper again. You need not to go with alignment, whether those are correct or not. Everything will be as per general offline question paper only. You will be getting all options. The only thing is the format will be little bit different. Instead of putting A, B, C, D, they should mark. They should tick a mark. Let me show example. This thing. So I am opening this form. So here the option is mobile number. Here we are given a field. They will write down with pen this, and they will check this box with pen. And here also, for every option we are given. See how many points you want to give us. If they want to give 2, they will check this box, 2 box. Please provide your Google form link. They will write down here. But anyhow, when you are conducting quiz, you don't ask this kind of link. We will be asking questions. So I hope you got it, the importance of this print option, getting PDF. Okay, I hope you got it, right? Everyone, please respond. Vijay Menon responded, Sudhamati responded. I request Prabhakaran sir to respond. Prabhakaran sir, Shantini Prabhakaran sir, please do respond. Priyadarshini madam responded. Okay, done. Okay, so now we have seen the settings also. We have seen preview also. We have this main settings also, print option. Script editor, just now I said, if students are entering, doing some malfunction, they are using their other number every time. Those kind of things you can solve with the help of script editor. This is somewhat advanced. Advanced means whoever using Google Forms, whoever working in software under code development side, they will go with this script editor. Or if you are good enough to know the knowledge of, if you are having knowledge of coding, you can go with the script editor. But for this, you need some kind of training, some kind of information from Google help. And one more option is add-ons. Add-ons, tomorrow I will explain. 2 or 3 I will explain. With that, we can conclude. And one more is preferences. As of now, we don't want these preferences, because preferences is nothing but every time you don't want to give settings for every time. Collect email addresses for every form. If you want from now onwards, whatever the Google Forms you are going to create, for all the Google Forms, if you want to collect email addresses option, then you have to go with this. This is what some kind of default settings. My humble request is don't go with this, because form to form your settings may change. Don't use these preferences. Add-ons tomorrow we will see. Script editor is somewhat advanced. The last one, add collaborator. With this I will conclude. We will go with your valuable suggestion and feedback and your doubts. Add collaborator is very simple. Now two things are there. After this session, tomorrow you please practice. The assignment is two-dimensional, multiple choice grid and checkbox grid. You practice that. While you are practicing, if you are facing any kind of problem, the first step is you just ping me personally. Be ready with the TeamViewer. Just now I have shown the TeamViewer screen. Let me show it again. TeamViewer. After installing TeamViewer, when you click that TeamViewer icon, you will be getting this kind of screen. Are you able to see this screen? Anyone please respond. Unmute yourself, please respond. Are you able to see this? Please don't. Anyone please?
Yes, sir.
Ah, okay, done. So after this, you please share this. We will be connecting with remotely. Okay, just whether you got this screen or not, that is good enough. If you get this screen, you please share in WhatsApp. For what purpose? If you are having any doubt while creating your assignment. That is one method. The one more wonderful method is add collaborator. Add collaborator. For this, I require one participant mail ID. Please give any mail ID. Anyone please put in chat box, I will copy. Anyone who are using laptop, whoever using laptop, professor sir, can you? You give your mail ID. I will go with RK Sudhamati madam. Madam, do you have, I will use you both. I will use your both mail IDs. Control C, Control V, comma, and I want to take one more. Sir, mail ID, Control V, comma, let me take Priyadarshini madam. Control C and paste. I think everyone knows this, how to include multiple email IDs. Just use comma as separator. Okay. Now, after adding editors, see the name itself, editors. That means now these three people can edit my form. That means we are a team. We four are a team. We are working on some project. We are doing this assignment. Okay. While doing some assignment, these four can access equally because I have given option editor. Automatically it will come under editor only because I choose collaborative. Automatically when I click collaborative, automatically it will come editor only. Okay. So here I am messaging. Here is our form. Please go through it and correct if any mistakes, like this, something you have written. What we are giving collaboration work, webinar assignment submission form. Editors will be able to view and delete form responses also. Okay, that is there like some kind of caution. So send, the moment when I click send, it is asking because I am using because some mail ID is out of domain, Gmail domain, it is asking anyone holding this invitation will have access, share anyway. If they restrict, we cannot do anything, but Gmail domain, it is okay. Now it is sending. I request those who are given these three mail IDs, please check your mail and do response in chat box whether you received or not any kind of invitation. Based on your response, I will explain the live mode, what you can do. Okay. Please use chat box whether you received any invitation mail. Please check your mail. rksudhamati@gmail.com. Madam, did you get? Yes. Next. Professor, did you get any mail? Next. Priyadarshini, madam, did you get any mail? Invitation mail? No. Just wait for a while, madam. The reason might be your domain, pec.edu, is not allowing the invitation from other domain, gmail.com. It will allow from only pec.edu. Some kind of settings will be there that is done by your admin. Okay. So I will go with first Sudhamati madam. I am stopping my screen. You start sharing your screen. I stopped my screen. Sudhamati madam, please start your screen. Can you present your screen?
Okay, sir.
Are you using mobile phone or laptop, madam?
A laptop, sir.
Please start sharing your screen, madam. You start sharing your screen.
Can you see the screen, sir?
As of now, we don't. Let me check with others. Where it is presenting, madam, your end? You will get some kind of options whether you are presenting or not. That will, your end, you can know first. What option you are using, madam? Present now option will be there. After clicking
that, yes, sir.
After clicking that present now, you choose the entire screen.
Yeah,
now. The entire screen. Okay. The moment you check, you click entire screen, then it will slowly start presenting screen.
Yes, sir. I have given share. Shares I have given. Share your entire screen.
Okay, we will wait, madam, whether we are getting. We are unable to see your screen, I think so, as of now. Present screen.
I'll do it again, sir.
Okay. Madam, if you do properly, you will get an option to stop. You will get an option to stop also. If you are not getting option to stop, that means you are not started.
I am going into present now option. From there, I think I have to choose
yes.
Your entire screen option.
Yes. Select your entire screen. Then it will give some kind of text, something your screen is presenting, something it will give some acknowledgement. Did you get? Because our side we are not getting any screen sharing.
It is just giving me a window where it shows share your entire screen.
You select. Yes, I got it. You select that, madam. You select that share entire. Once it is selected, down the line you will get the share option like enabled mode. Unable to do it, madam?
Yes, sir.
Okay, madam. I will use this opportunity to explain how to share your screen in Google Meet. Okay, madam?
Sir.
Please. Present now. I am starting present now my screen. I will show one example how to do it. Now are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In fact, everything we can ask Google only. Google Amma will give all answers how to share the screen in Google Meet. From laptop. Okay. I want to go with some images. It is giving so many options. Let me take my images. I cannot record myself again. Just wait. Choose images option because now playing the video it is not possible for me. Right. So your doubt is this, right, madam? This one, right? Your doubt is?
Yes, madam? Sir.
Yes. Once you are there in this place, just wait, madam. I did a mistake again. Showing somewhere else. Please, I'm sorry, just wait, because this is very common thing we must know, because everyone will face this kind of problem. Please let us use this option
in this time to know. Open image in new tab. I have selected wrong. Yes. So now, when you are asked to this kind of question, here this share option is noted in blue color. See, this share option is noted in blue color. You have to select any one of it here.
Okay.
This you have to select one. When you select that, then it will enable. Then you click share. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, madam, you do it now.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Yes. Now you are able to share your screen, madam.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Actually. Now, where we are? Collaborative, right? I forgot actual where we are. Okay. So now, again, you just close it, madam. Just wait. Now you close this.
Stop sharing.
No. You don't stop. Form? You don't stop. Generally, okay.
I'll close the form.
Webinar assessments. You close it. That is your practice, right, madam?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now you go to forms.google.com. Forms.google.com. In other window, not in meet window. Forms.google.com. 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 Press enter. I hope everyone is able to see madam's screen. Okay. Madam, now. Yesterday I explained one setting owned by anyone, owned by me. One option will be
yes,
there.
Sir.
Yes, go to there. Owned by me.
No.
You select not owned by me. Let me check whether it is not updated. Again you select madam. You have given proper mail ID, right, madam?
Yes, sir.
Again you select one more option. Not owned by me. What is the other option? Owned by anyone. Actually, it should be reflected. Yes, madam. Student personal information in collaborative mode. Other than that, what is webinar assignment submission? You go search in search. Use search option, madam. Upside. Webinar assignment submission. Webinar assignment. You check the spelling of webinar, madam. Because it will select you webinar. If it is not working, we will go with other mail ID. It should come. 716. It is not coming. What mail ID you have given, madam?
So I have given rksudhamadi@gmail.com.
Gmail.com. I have sent properly only. But yesterday only we have checked with my Tirupati sir that one.
But it also shows the Google form also shows my official mail ID is official mail ID is Google form.
Oh, acha. Right. Okay, madam. Right now, top right side, your photo is there. What is that account, madam? What is that actual?
That account is my official mail ID.
Yes. Now you change. You click it. There you see. Because of you, we learnt two things, madam. One is how to share the screen. Another thing is always we have to be in one Gmail account in which we are working. Okay,
sir.
Now it is came. Madam, now you don't. It is there, madam, already. Because it is first time, it is there. And now, madam, one icon is there. One icon is there. That people icon is there, right? Here only, in the form itself. Webinar assignment submission form is there, na?
Yes, sir. People icon.
That is what? Collaborative. So
okay,
that form
sir.
Is in collaborative mode. You just open it. you just open it?
Yeah, I'm opening it.
Okay.
I have opened it.
Okay. Madam, you select any one question. Mobile number question you select. Just mobile number. Madam, this is like first tour. This is like first tour. Whoever open first time, it will give some kind of tutorial. Okay. Be there, madam. Don't do anything now. Now I am selecting the first section, first question. That is now I have selected. This is for assignment submission. That title I have selected. That is in green color. That is in green color. And
yes,
next
sir.
Question you have selected. That is in blue color.
Yes, sir.
Generally, you will find this kind of thing when in spreadsheet when you are working in collaborative mode. Okay. So now you just move your cursor over to that green color. Just move over to the green color.
I have moved.
No. Okay, wait. You didn't get my point. Let me select mobile number. You go to green color. You come outside. First you come outside. Like just move your cursor outside. Go to green color. Don't go to question, just green color. Don't select, madam. Don't select. You need not to select.
Okay, sir.
Just be there. I am selected again. This is for assignment submission. I am editing right now. You are in mobile number. Okay.
Okay.
Just move your cursor over there. Don't select that particular type question. Just move over there. You move your cursor over there. That's it. That color side, green color side, corner, green color.
Good. Yes, sir. I have moved.
Can you find my name over there? Like gmail.com or my mail will come there. This side, madam, right? Left side, green color. Left side.
Yes, sir.
What you have seen, Purna.Vangara.
Yes, sir.
What that means, I am editing that particular section. You are editing mobile number. This is what collaborative work. I am working on something
sir.
And you are working on something. We are doing on same form, but we are reducing our time. Okay, you do this
sir.
Question, I will do this question. Just for example, I am giving. So now you can do anything.
Okay.
This is also we can use for tomorrow. One option is TeamViewer. And other option is also this one. We will go in both cases. We will on a call, our phone call.
Okay.
We will be on our phone call. We will be using this either TeamViewer or this option. So if you stuck up at any place, anything, if you are having doubt, I will do that. You can understand.
Okay, sir. Okay. Understood.
Right. With this today's session, whatever I want to convey, that is, I hope I completed. Tomorrow add-ons I will explain. And anything is missing, I will explain. And we will discuss your doubts also. Okay. Now you can stop your screen sharing, madam.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now the participants count is only 16. Just you give your attendance. Just give your presence in comment form. I will take that copy for my TLC purpose. You just put anything. Say present, just present in comment, chat box. Everyone, whoever there in 16, you just say present. Because I need this for my record purpose. How many registered, how many attended day wise. You just click present. Okay. Thank you. Almost everyone responded. Okay. So this is it for today, 8:10. So now I will take few participants' response who are not yet responded, not yet introduced themselves. Now I am giving chance to others. Anyhow, we have 16. We can discuss with everyone. We can discuss with everyone because we have time. Just 10 minutes, we will wind up. One by one, please. Praveen Kumar, sir. Praveen Kumar, sir. Please unmute yourself. Please discuss with us. Give your comments. And any doubts are there, please ask us. Praveen Kumar, sir.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Very nice session. I can understand everything. I don't have any doubt at all.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Sir, have you done your Google form? You created any Google form previously?
Yeah, yeah. But I have not posted in the group. I have practiced quickly Google forms yesterday.
Okay. My intention is that you have to practice. That's it, sir. Because when you practice, yeah, then only we can understand. That is my intention. Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Next, I will go with Chaitanya. Chaitanya, madam, please. Madam, you can unmute yourself, please. Chaitanya, madam. Okay, I will go with Satya Parthipan. Sir, can you unmute yourself? Sarah has given one message. Your presentation is
Hello.
Good. Ah, yes. Ah, madam, sorry. You can go ahead, madam.
Okay, sir, the presentation is good.
Yes,
whatever things that you are explaining, it is very clear. We are able to follow, but then I didn't practice so much.
Okay,
whatever
madam.
Things that you have taught, but I need to have more hands-on.
Okay, madam.
So if I do that hands-on, definitely I think I'll be comfortable with
it. Yes, madam. Yes, madam. This is Google Forms. We are learning online tool. We need practice. You, whenever you have some doubt, you just ping me, madam. Tomorrow.
Sure.
We will. I will come online. We can do together. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Just
yes,
one session.
Yes.
Just Thank 1 hour or just few minutes is enough, madam. Good enough.
Okay, sir. Okay, sure.
Thank you so much, madam.
Thank you, sir.
I request other participants. I am giving chance to them only. Anyone wants to speak, please unmute yourself and you can talk. You can go ahead, so that I can conclude. It's already 8:12. Anyone, please unmute yourself and you can say a few words. Let us go with Sudhamati, madam. You already unmuted yourself. You are already
there. Yes,
please give,
yes,
us,
sir, like,
give us feedback, madam.
Yes, as other participants told, like today's class, we could able to understand. The thing is that we have to practice it and see.
Yes, yes, madam. Because yesterday we started basics. Today somewhat in depth.
Yes, sir.
Okay. As of now, my suggestion is you don't go with that regular expression option. Just go with general questions, general validation. That is good enough.
Okay.
Once you practice, then you go with regular expression. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sure.
Based on the participant doubts, tomorrow I will explain add-ons. Because based on today's session, I understood we need to practice more on Google form itself. No need to go for add-ons,
yes,
as of now. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Professor, sir, please, you give your words with your words because it's already time 8:14. Give your words. We will close it, sir.
Sir, we will practice it in the night, sir. You can send the webinar recordings today.
Yes, sir.
As you did it yesterday, and okay, we will have a more practice, and we will come out with more doubts tomorrow.
Okay, okay. More doubts are coming. Means, I always say in my class, sir. Like one thing. The very first thing when I enter into class, if you ask doubts, then only I can learn. I can learn.
Correct.
What I am doing is, I am teaching to learn. You correct. Are learning to teach.
To teach. Correct. Correct.
I am teaching to learn and you are learning to teach. That is the motto, sir.
And
okay,
the way you are expressing and communicating is very excellent, sir. Again, I am congratulating.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much, sir. You are kind.
Thank
you,
sir. Thank you.
So
thank
let
you.
Us on our video, you please enable your video. Let us see how we look today. Let's give a high five. Everyone, I request
to enable their video. I am enabling my video, just wait. I request everyone. Yes. Are you able to see me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, just I think Shobana Madam, Rajkumar, Shobana S, Chaitanya. Please just for a second, just on your screen, your video, just give a high five and you can leave. And you can leave the meeting. Just give a bye. Just a bye wave is enough. Good night. So we can wind up now. So please leave the session after giving a high five. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, madam. Sudhamith, madam, thank you so much.
Okay, sir.